Hello aspirants, welcome to AKMIS Academy. In this video, we are going to discuss about kafala system, which is considered as modern day slavery. So as many students have requested to make this video, I have done this so for the benefit of the student community. Let's understand in this video what is kafala system, where it is prevailing, what are the terms and conditions, why it is going to be considered as a form of slavery, and all other aspects we'll be discussing. So first thing you have to understand is this kafala system is an agreement type of, or you can say sponsorship based employment system, which is prevalent in many of the Gulf countries. For example, Saudi Arabia, UAE, Bahrain, and even with respect to Kuwait and Qatar also. So you have many countries using this particular kafala system to have economic growth. But why is this system so much criticized? Let's understand in this discussion. But before that, you have to know what is the location of Kuwait. So this is in news because of Kuwait. And you know, in the recent times, we have a Kuwait fire accident in a complex where even 41 Indian migrant workers have lost their lives. So this incident has brought the attention of the entire country as a whole towards this kafala system of, because all the Indians who have lost their lives, that is 41 Indians, all those were engaged as part of this kafala system in Kuwait. So let us understand what is the system and why this particular system is getting criticized by everyone. So let us understand what is the brief context. I told you the brief context. Let us understand what is this kafala system. Kafala means a system where there is a sponsorship by the employer. Employer is considered here as kafil. Locally, he will be called as kafil. That is why we call it as kafala system. And this sponsorship is given by the employer towards his migrant unskilled worker. This is what the kafala system is. So what is worker? Okay. So what is this kafala system means? Here he has to sponsor. That means the person who is giving the employment, he has to sponsor his worker. So in this regard, what is happening? Why they have introduced this system in many Gulf countries like Saudi Arabia, UAE, Bahrain, Kuwait, and all these countries means, first thing is they wanted to have economic growth. So when there is a demand for labor, to ensure that there will be cheap supply of the labor, they have introduced such system where the sponsorship will be there. Sponsorship means through some agencies, they will be hiring the foreign workers who are unskilled to stimulate their economic growth by different activities, economic activities. Where these particular persons are working mostly who are hired under kafala system means, in oil refineries, you have generally seen oil refineries. Then in building constructions, hotels and all, there also you'll be seeing. And sorrowing thing is, in Kuwait alone, okay, where the incident happened, in only in Kuwait, you have almost 10 lakh Indian workers who are working. 10 lakh Indian workers are working here. And most of them are under this kafala system. What happens under the system is, once you enter under the system, what happens? The person who is giving you the employment, he will take control over everything with respect to you. Even your passport and travel documents will be confiscated. So you cannot change your job. You have to listen to his terms and conditions. So it is leading to the exploitation as well as abuse. So confiscation of passport and travel documents also. And the persons, in case if they have to change the job also, or the nature of the employment, they have to get a no objection certificate, which is very difficult here. And it is leading to poor wages also. And there are very poor working conditions also. That means he's becoming a modern day slave in his master's hands. That is why the system is considered as a modern form of slavery. And it is also considered as a form of forced labor. And you know, Indian constitution doesn't allow forced labor, and it is implicitly and explicitly banning such form of forced labor or bonded labor under Article 23 of Indian constitution. Then why is this system still prevailing is, again, you know, as these countries are advancing and they have to achieve the rapid economic growth, they wanted to ensure cheap supply of the labor. So most of the Indian persons are working, and this particular proportion of Indian workers in Kuwait, like employment sector, if you have seen, that constitutes almost 30% of the workforce from India itself. That is how you can understand what is the importance of these workers in their economy. But still, they're not reciprocating it in the same way. So they're tightening the norms so that these people cannot enter the country easily, and they cannot leave the country easily, by confiscating all the travel related documents, and they're increasing the troublesome situations. Even in Qatar, if you have remembered, in Qatar it has hosted FIFA World Cup of 2022. At that time, to compensate all the persons who are visiting for that World Cup and all, and they have to arrange all these things, right? For that particular thing, they have started constructing many buildings and infrastructural things. At that time, it was scorching heat in Qatar. Almost 50 degrees is the temperature that was recorded. But still, they have asked all these workers to work in that particular temperatures of 50 degrees, because of which almost 5,000 people died. Not only from India, from many countries people have died in that, working in that particular heat. So there are always demonstrations and all these things going on. There's like, they're raising the voice against the system, but still these countries are again thinking to withdraw the system. They're not ensuring that the system is going to be withdrawn soon, but this system is definitely considered as a modern form of slavery itself. So let us expect that a better condition has to be provided, because it is a clear violation of human right according to Human Rights Commission, or also even according to the International Labour Organization also, it is clear violation of labour rights. So you have to provide decent conditions of work. So these are not getting implemented under the kafala system. So this is a brief introduction, and you have to know Kuwait is also part of a political and economic organization among Gulf countries, that is Gulf Cooperation Council. So this is all for this video. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.